on a night when three world titles will be decided. The best of the best athletes on the planet take center stage. Two of the most exciting grapplers eye the most coveted world title in the sport. A display of striking at the highest level in the world. And two sons of Brazil battle to stand atop the Bantamweight division. Tonight, live from
Kuala Lumpur,
it's ONE on Prime Video 3. Lineker versus Andrade.
Morning on the other side of the world in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Welcome to ONE on Prime Video 3, Lineker versus Andrade. Inside the Axiata Arena, it is prime time back in the United States, and we cannot wait. How about a glad you're along, Brent Stover, circle side, alongside the former ONE fighter, the Dragon Mitch Chilson, and the Hall of Famer, it's Rich Ace Franklin. A massive night of fights. It gets no better than this. There will be electrifying fights all night long behind us inside the ONE circle. Cannot wait. Three world titles on the line, including lightweight submission grappling, 19-year-old American sensation Kade Ruotolo. And that, Mitch, is just the start of the excitement.
Oh, lightweight Muay Thai gold will finally be decided inside the circle. The dominant five-time kickboxing champion, Regian Eersel, takes on Sinsamut Klinmee, the knockout artist that has lit the Muay Thai world on fire. But that main event, Rich.
There is some bad blood between John Lineker and Fabricio Andrade. Two stylistically different stand-up fighters, not looking for this one to go to the ground. However, Lineker didn't make weight this week, so he's been stripped of the title. But Andrade, if he wins, can still walk away with the gold.
Three world title fights on the main card, five total fights. We mentioned Kade Ruotolo in submission grappling. You two talked about the co-main and the main events, but don't sleep on that fight. Featherweight kickboxing, Sidichai and Mohamed Batassa, Kim Jae-ung, Kasanov, a newcomer as well. Going to be fun to watch. That is exclusively on Prime Video 2 hours from now for the main card. In the meantime, here's the lead card, and Mitch, do not sleep because we have four incredible firefights coming up on this lead card.
Woo! Small gloves Muay Thai, Asa Ten Pow makes his debut against a very tough veteran in Mehdi Zatout. I'm really looking forward to that fight.
Tell you what, now Danial Williams made himself known in those small gloves Muay Thai against Ruotang. However, he switched over to MMA. He's on a roll, but he's facing his toughest test yet in Jeremy Miado.
Naseri and Naito is going to be incredible as well. That's flyweight Muay Thai. That'll be the third fight of the night. But to kick it off, this one is going to be electric in the women's division. A couple of newcomers, the youngster, 26-year-old from France and Thailand, making her ONE debut, Noelle Grandjean, against another young American sensation, the 20-year-old from the United States, training out of Sacramento, making her pro debut, it is Lea Bivins. So it's the exciting young talent, Bivins, against the undefeated Grandjean. What a way to kick off this night, the first of nine bouts in ONE championship.
The most competitive women's mixed martial arts division on the planet adds even more excitement as Lea Bivins and Noelle Grandjean arrive. Inspired to compete in ONE by atomweight world champion Angela Lee, the road for Bivins begins here.
I've always wanted to be a professional fighter since I was a little girl.
I'm definitely very confident in my skills. I wouldn't have taken the fight if I wasn't, and I don't look for any easy fights.
But on a journey all her own, undefeated judo black belt, Noelle Grandjean. after moving to Phuket, Thailand to train at the prestigious Tiger Muay Thai Gym. Little Monkey can't wait to show that she can throw bodies with the same ferocity as she throws hands.
I was a Dutch, French, and Thai national champion in judo. I come from a martial arts family. My dad was also a fighter. Because my dad was also doing MMA, I always felt that I was about to switch. I was just waiting for this moment. I'm willing to do this. My dad, he will be in my corner, and I hope I will make him proud.
Tonight, I'm seeing the night ending with my hand being raised.
Lea Bivins versus Noelle Grandjean, next.
Representing Thailand and France, Noelle Lil Monkey Grandjean.
Noelle Grandjean, 26 years old, from France and Thailand. Her much anticipated one debut tonight. First few years of her life, she grew up in the Netherlands, became a national judo champ in France and the Netherlands. She has got a promising future with that judo background. Says, I'm not a talker, I am a doer. I am in my own world when I get inside the one circle. She gets the opportunity to prove herself as we kick off this phenomenal card here tonight, Mitch.
Yeah, Brent, she might not be a talker, but I do believe she's a singer, because this is her on the mic going down that aisle, singing her own walkout music. Noelle is a nasty high-level judoka. She's got a second-degree black belt. She's got national championships in three different countries. And now she's making her way into mixed martial arts, and she's really gonna need to lean on that judo here tonight, because Bivins is very aggressive. What I like about Noelle is her commitment to judo and really kind of bring judo into mixed martial arts, Rich.
Yeah, you know, Noelle, her judo is top of the line. However, Bivins has a strong wrestling background. So, for me, if I were in Noelle's camp, I would be advising her, put Bivins against the cage. That way it'll isolate her, keep Bivins from moving. She's a very mobile athlete. This way, Noelle can earn those takedowns that she'd be looking for.
That's her father in the corner right there. So this is a family affair, because Lea also has her father in her corner. Let's break down Noelle a little bit deeper. She has her striking base kind of based in Muay Thai. She likes to put things together, especially inside that clinch. Again, she's a second degree judo black belt. She spent her entire life training in the Japanese martial art judo. She's very good at the hip tosses. She can use it defensively, and she's gonna have to lean on that because Lea is such an explosive wrestler.
Absolutely.
So she's trained more than ever for this fight with a new focus.
From the USA, Lea Fishbone Bivins.
Lea Bivins trains out of Sacramento. The young American, 20 years of age. Her professional debut is tonight. Doing MMA since she could walk when she was 3 years old. Started BJJ at the age of 4. Win a trip to Singapore for one on Prime Video 4. Cannot wait for that.
I'll tell you what I can't wait for is the debut of Lea Bivins. I've heard a lot about this young lady. She was dominant on kind of the amateur scene, and she's really put together a good streak of wins. She's raised in a household of martial artists. Her father, Anthony, is in her corner right there, and he's really put together an interesting game plan for this matchup. Now, Rich, do you think she's gonna go after the wrestling and try to clinch and tangle with the judoka, or do you think she's gonna try to keep it on her feet and strike?
I'll tell you, I've seen Bivins in one match, and this girl, she comes out explosively and gets it done. She doesn't waste any time, so I look at her for the clinch.
She's also really good in that BJJ. She started early, just 5 years old. She's trained at United MMA with the Lees, and she's taken a lot of inspiration from the Lee family in just their progression in mixed martial arts. She comes from a similar background. She's won a lot of the same, you know, youth tournaments, and she's really here to not just take part, but to take over.
Yeah, she's actually spent a lot of time out in Hawaii with the Lees. She's helping Victoria train for her debut when she came into ONE Championship.
The sky's the limit for this young 20-year-old. And we've been looking forward to this for the last several weeks. What a way to kick it off here tonight. Tail of the tape, Lea Bivins, 20 years of age, Grandjean, 26. 5-inch height advantage for the American Bivins, and a 2-pound weight advantage in this catchweight bout. Our global rules. Take a look here. Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, live from the Axiata Arena, this is One on Prime Video 3, Lineker versus Andrade. And now we begin with the first match of the evening. 3 5-minute rounds of a 117-pound catchweight MMA contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, she stands at 5 feet tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, training out of Tiger Muay Thai, representing Thailand and France, Noelle Grandjean. Introducing her opponent out of the red corner. She stands at 5 feet, 5 inches tall, weighing in at 117 pounds, training out of House of Moons, representing the United States of America, Lea First Moon Bivins. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Herb Dean. Let's go,
Herb! We've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. You're gonna keep it clean. Touch gloves, let's do it.
So Herb Dean, and these two fighters ready to go. Bivins and Grandjean. Good way to start this night as fans filing in, the doors are open, the first of 9 fights. 2 hours from now, we go exclusively on Prime Video for the main card, but this lead card should be electrifying, including this one with Bivins, the 20-year-old, Grandjean, the 26-year-old, 3 5-minute rounds in the MMA division.
Ooh, Bivins immediately gets inside that clinch, tries to close that distance, utilizing those short-range strikes. Let's see what Noelle has an answer for.
I wonder if Bivins trying to make a statement here going right into the clinch.
Nice. Outside trip right there from Noelle Grandjean as Bivins is on her back now. You can see Grandjean's trying to attack those legs. Bivins is trying to tie her up, trying to close in, trying to enter in through the legs. Gets a hold of that arm, gets her into full guard. This is where Bivins does really good work. She's got nice triangles. She's really active off her back.
And Rich, you saw some phenomenal stuff on the tape from Bivins when she was just a youngster. Her ability to dominate everybody who gets inside the circle or the ring or wherever it is with her.
Yeah, absolutely. Mitch said it right, though. She stays very active, whether she's on top or bottom. You can see she had very long limbs. When she first established that guard, she went to a body triangle immediately. She's working the hips here, trying to isolate that left arm, or the right arm of Noelle, I should say. And Noelle's wise to that and squaring herself back up again. But again, you can see the body triangle. Like, she's got a lot of flexibility, a lot of options to be able to work off of this.
Yeah, but that body triangle is not really doing too much off the bottom like that. All she's doing is holding Noelle on top of her, and this is a bad spot for her. She needs to open up that guard and start being a little bit more active. I like how she's trying to hold the hands and she's trying to hand fight here, but look at the way Noelle is attacking her left arm and bringing it across her body, so that's gonna open up her left side. Now Lee is walking her way up to a high guard, trying to attack that arm bar. Good job by Noelle to see it coming and move away.
Work. Nearly 2 minutes into this fight. Again, 3 5-minute rounds. This, the catchweight division. Bivins missed weight, so becomes a catchweight. But a pro debut here for Bivins and a one debut for Grandjean. And now Herb Dean steps in and gets them back on their feet in the center of the one circle.
This is where Bivins really needs to utilize that reach advantage that she's got. She's got to start putting out that jab and just earn some respect. She's trying to close the distance, but every time she does, she gets touched by that right hand.
Went in for the straight left and now back into the clinch. Straight right coming back from Grandjean. A couple of knees inside the clinch from Bivins.
See Grandjean starting to step through there, looking for that setup.
Oh, there's a takedown.
Oh, good defense by Bivins, though.
Absolutely. Back to their feet. Really working the knees is Bivins, and now they separate here.
Bivins got hit with it the first time, but she was wise to it the second time.
Out of that southpaw stance, the American, again, who trains out of Sacramento, Lea Bivins. And you mentioned earlier, both fighters with their fathers in their respective corners here.
Yeah, it's a family affair to kick us off here at One on Prime Video 3.
How good is this lead card, huh,
Mitch? Yeah, it's pretty good right now, but right now I want to see Lea be a little bit more active on her feet. She's got to earn some respect. There she goes. Seems like she's slowed down. I know she missed weight, so she looks a little bit fatigued right here. She's got to start putting out that jab and start touching the shorter Grandjean.
90 seconds to go into round one. Again, the fight judged as a whole here in MMA and one championship. Instead of round by round.
Nice high guard from Lea. She's trying to step in, but she's got to start putting out that jab. Need to find her range. Loosen up, maybe get her second wind here. She seems to be slowed down quite a bit.
Outside leg kicks here from Grandjean, trying to mix things up a little bit on her attack here in the later stage of the opening round. Straight right there, and then follows with the knee. Oh, big time shots, and now hammer fists on the ground, and that's it. Her team calls it in the first round. Grandjean, what a debut in one championship to kick us off, Mitch.
Grandjean just stepped in, unloaded with a body shot, and you could immediately see Lea Bivins did not want any more of that.
I blinked, and I didn't know that it was the body shot that dropped her, and she was not protesting.
Yeah, she was like, nope, I don't want none of that smoke. I am out of this. And she sat down, waved it off. Watch this. She steps in, boom, right to the body, and Bivins is like, nope, I can't handle none of that. Herb Dean jumps in, pulls Grandjean off. Nice debut for Noelle Grandjean.
Look at that, straight right to the body, Mitch. Woo-hoo. And she waved it off right there, Bivins, looking at Herb Dean, saying that's it. And then following, just for good measure, some icing on the cake here from Grandjean. Well, to make it official as this one ends in the opening round to start the night, we send it to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Herb Dean, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 1 second in the very first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Noelle Grandjean!
Noelle Grandjean, impressive stuff in her one debut. It gets you really excited to see how far she can go. All right, inside the one circle again, the Dragon, Mitch Chilson.
Noelle, I know the judo is your strength, and that's what you planned on using. You used it early, but when did you ever envision a knockout finish?
Actually, I wanted to finish the first round, and I'm happy to get this. All respect to Lea. She's a very good opponent. Very strong BJJ. Actually, I feel also very good on the ground. I should have trusted myself first a bit more, but still got the first round finished. I'm so happy about this.
Did you see a weakness to the body? Did you know that's where you wanted to go, or did you just react in the moment? Because I want you to take a look up here at the big screen and walk us through this.
Yes, I feel I got good power, and it was open, so we also worked on this with my team. My dad, Tiger Muay Thai, Robert, thanks to be here. Thanks, everyone. Yes, we got this.
Well, how soon do you want to get back in here, and who would you like to see as an opponent?
I'm always on wait. I'm out here in Phuket. I'm waiting for my next shot. I'm ready to fight anytime.
Well, I think you might have been the underdog in this one, and you shocked the world, but I've got a shock for you because you just got $50,000 from Chachri Sinyatong. Thoughts on that?
Thanks from the bottom of my heart. I live in Thailand, and this changed my life forever. I'm so happy, and I told one before, I will never disappoint you. I'll make a show every time I come in and inside of the circle as well. I'm always happy, I'm always smiling, but I can show the hard work as well.
Well, whether you're singing on the mic or performing inside the circle, it was fun to watch you perform. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Noelle Grandjean.
Oh, wow, the 26-year-old representing her two countries impressively. Man, that was dominant. You talk about making a splash in one championship. That's about as good as it gets.
And she shocked the world because we all expected this to happen on the ground. I don't think anybody, myself included, after viewing tapes of her, expected her to have a knockout win, particularly with a body shot.
What a way to kick it off. So four fights on this lead card coming up at 10 p.m. Eastern back in the United States, the main card, which features five fights and three world titles. This is going to be a phenomenal night, and this will be a phenomenal fight next. Bantamweight Muay Thai, the American Asa Ten Pow, Mehdi Zatout. That is on the other side of the break in Malaysia.
Each. Oh, good start from Bucci. Oh, but he gets caught and it's finished.
It's got its own gravitational pull. Charges after Gilani early. Looking for a takedown and trying to put hands. Oh, Gilani catches it!
The spinning back fist. Spinning back fist looking to finish and he does!
Very successful one, unbeaten in his three contests.
Juanel is coming off a nasty heel hook submission.
Oh, he got the big kibosh! Juanel, the hammer fist strike!
Michel Ahmed has really been focused on his footwork and his stand-up boxing.
Good hands from him.
Oh, and Jimmy Yabo comes out of nowhere.
Urujai said he did more sparring in training in this camp than ever before. Kelly knocks out the Cambodian. This place will go bananas. Oh, there's the left hook. Oh, and he does that. Listen.
As she did that, she let her guard get past.
Now, oh, a heavy hand. Ev's got to be careful not to drop his gloves too low. Oh, Ev King in trouble. It's good night, Irene.
Early morning here in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, back in the United States, prime time. What a way to start this lead card. Getting set for the second fight of the night, Bantamweight Muay Thai, the American Asa Ten Pow, one of the standout athletes in the American kickboxing and Muay Thai scene, takes on a crafty veteran in Mehdi Zatout.
There is no doubt that ONE is home to the absolute best strikers on the planet. Asa Ten Pow is the newest addition to a world championship roster.
I fought for the consensus number one spot in America to become the face, the number one American, and I'm carrying that torch now.
The American Ninja is ready to establish himself on the sport's biggest stage.
Yeah, he's a superstar in America, but I'm a superstar over the world, you know.
With over 100 bouts to his name, Muay Thai world champion Mehdi Zatout is a dangerous competitor.
Nobody can pass me. I'm still hungry. I'm working very hard over 25 years. I want people to remember my name.
He's got the experience. Nongo, Capitan. He's been around the game. It's a great opportunity for me. It's a great challenge. I wouldn't want it any other way.
C'est un grand show. Il est vraiment pas prêt pour ça. Vous allez voir.
If I'm not ready, get me out of there. Don't dance around. Show me.
I always pushing forward. I don't play safe to win by points.
You put on those 4-ounce gloves, there will be blood, there will be KOs, there will not be decisions.
Asa Ten Pow versus Mehdi Zatout is next.
Mehdi Zatout has a big time experience advantage in the fight.
Algeria.
This is his 120th pro fight. Veteran world champion returning to his favorite, Muay Thai. Says, I want to show I can do anything and everything. I got speed. I've been working on my eyes. Very well. Literally and figuratively. He's focused on that $50,000 bonus, he told us in the fighter meetings earlier this week. Again, a veteran, former world champion. And he's bounced between kickboxing and Muay Thai, like a lot of guys, but not everybody can be at the top of both. And Mehdi Zatout, Mitch, has been able to do that here in one championship.
Yeah, and you say he's been training those eyes, and the reason he's been able to stay on top is because of his reactions. He is so crafty, he is so smooth, he has a game plan and he sticks to it. He's a veteran inside the circle and pretty much everywhere else. This guy is so good in a lot of different areas. He runs Venom Fight Team, he's the manager of all those competitors, but he still has that passion, that fire that burns inside of him, and he really wants to light the circle on fire tonight, Rich.
I'll tell you, I like Mehdi Zatout's style. He's very calculated with what he does. He's a great counter striker. But what I'd like to see him do tonight is put a little pressure on Asa Ten Pow, because he does not deal well with that pressure that somebody's moving forward with him constantly.
But we've seen a lot from Mehdi in the past, and he likes to counter strike. He likes to let people come to him, make them miss, and then make them pay, which is not a good idea because Asa Ten Pow don't like to miss.
Absolutely. Asa Ten Pow is a good range fighter. And so is Zatout. But I think the path of least resistance here for him is to push forward on this and make Asa Ten Pow fight off that back foot.
Yeah, he doesn't want to get backed up. He wants to push forward. He wants to utilize that lateral movement and then counter. His right hand is a serious hammer. And he also has also got really good knees when his opponents try to close that distance. The WBC Muay Thai World Champion is a very technical striker, ladies and gentlemen. He's got fast, powerful hands, and it just goes to show you that he's got 43 career knockouts, Brent.
The man from Algeria, he looks relaxed. He looks to be in the best shape of his life. He's excited to get inside the circle.
Let's go, Mehdi. Let's go.
From the USA, Asa, the American Ninja,
Asa Ten Pow trains out of Florida. Was ranked as one of the top kickboxers in the world. An exciting fighter with a Chinese background. Coming off of an 8-week camp. Draped in the United States flag. The stars and stripes. And he really leans in and loves the fact that he gets to represent the United States here on Prime Video tonight in prime time back in the United States.
You know, it's great to see, you know, the red, white, and blue draped across his shoulders. I really like this young man. I've been waiting for him to come to One Super Series and showcase his style of kickboxing. He's really fun to watch. He's coming off of a big TKO victory over the former champion, Kevin Ross. He looked really dominant in that matchup. He's got good boxing and strong, powerful low kicks. But this guy likes to spin too. He's very flashy. He likes to put on a show. And this guy's never been KO'd too, so you know he's got a chance.
I'll tell you, what I like about Asa is his very unorthodox style. He'll spin, he'll throw axe kicks, and he'll come at you from different angles that you're just not used to seeing. And that's something that Zatout is gonna need to look out for tonight.
Yeah, when it comes to Asa Ten Pow, you know, he comes from that Wushu Sanshao style where he likes to be flashy. He likes to put on really, really exciting performances. He's got a 12-2 pro record, 6 career knockouts. So 50% knockout ratio is pretty good. And a lot of it comes from those unorthodox moves, those fancy, flashy, powerful spin kicks.
If I was Ace's coach, I would advise him to use that unorthodox to put the pressure on Zatout and check his gas tank tonight in this match.
Because Mehdi's seen a lot. He's been around a long time, so maybe some of those unorthodox techniques might be in his favor.
Asa Ten Pow came into One because he wanted a chance to compete in free sports. Tail of the tape, 33 years of age. Asa Ten Pow, 39 years of age for Zatout. 1-inch reach advantage. for the American. Our global rule set for this fight. Three-minute rounds, 10-point must system. Three knockdowns in a round is a TKO. Here's Dom Lau.
Next up, we have three-minute rounds of bantamweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is a WBC Muay Thai world champion, standing at 5'8" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 78 wins and 40 losses. Training out of Venom Training Camp, representing Algeria, Mehdi Diamondheart Zatout. And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5'8" tall, weighing in at 144 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 12 wins and 2 losses. Training out of Florida Kickboxing Academy, representing the United States of America, Asa, the American Ninja, Ten Pow. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Justin Brown.
Guys, stay. You guys both know the rules. Let's keep this match clean. Let's watch the low blows. Obey my commands at all times. Defend yourself at all times, okay? Ready? Step back.
Man, they beat Justin Brown to the punch right there.
They did. They were already in the center waiting on him.
These guys are ready to go. This is really
stay
fun.
Stay back.
The fact that we get a cracker this early, we already had a first-round knockout. Catchweight MMA on the women's side. Noelle Grandjean taking down Lea Bivins with a knockout.
Let's go.
In the opening round there. Second fight of the night. Bantamweight Muay Thai. Asa Ten Pow from America. Mehdi Zatout from Algeria.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how Asa handles those small gloves. I know he's used to big gloves, but you know, Mehdi Zatout's been here. He's been inside the circle. He's used to the bright lights. Nice two-piece.
Oh, nice combo to open up. First 30 seconds of this one. A little catch and a fire back there from Asa Ten Pow. Looking that jab, judging the distance. A wild left hook there, didn't land. Straight right was nice. Wild head kick and a big shot on the counterattack from Zatout.
Asa's got to be careful with some of these kicks and punches because he oftentimes will get himself out of position where he exposes his back to his opponent like that with a big technique.
These 1-2 combos to begin. Zatout setting the tone early.
Yeah, Zatout is really clean boxing, man. He got caught right there by a left hand by Asa. Ooh, and he answers back with a right hand of his own. Asa said that Mehdi Zatout's got hands. That's his only weapon that he's got, but it's not even that good. So I think Mehdi really wants to put a beating on him with the hands.
It's an absolute firefight to begin. Oh, wild overhand right from Asa Ten Pow.
You can already see that tattoo that Asa's got on the right side of his body from one of those big kicks landed by Zatout. Now he's starting to taunt him. This is where Mehdi really starts to find his range and his timing. His hands come down, and he starts gunslinging from his hips.
Mehdi got the hands down. You're right. He's awfully confident in this opening round.
Yeah, it only took him about a minute and a half to figure out the timing and the rhythm of Asa.
Sends in flying back right there, Mitch.
Mehdi's got almost 10 times more experience than Asa, so he's really going to try to lean on that here.
It's that last technique that Asa threw that got him out of position again. What you don't understand is that it takes a lot longer to throw techniques like that. When you're against somebody like Mehdi Zatout, he knows how to read every little micro movement that's coming in the body way before the technique actually gets there.
A straight kick by Asa Ten Pow, mixing it up there.
Yeah, you said that Mehdi's been focusing on the eyes, and you can just see that. His hands are down, and he's just looking for these slight little micro movements of Asa so he can figure out where he's coming from. And the hands are down at his hips. And he's just almost egging Asa to come forward and throw something so he can counter.
Alrighty, some damage underneath the left eye as well as the right side of the body there of Asa Ten Pow, the American.
Good head movement so far early on. Are you surprised, Rich, by Mehdi going backwards as much as he is?
I am, only because Asa is typically a counter puncher, and I wouldn't expect him to pressure this much. I think it's a good idea that he's doing that. But if I were him, I would keep my feet on the ground a little bit more and depend on those boxing skills that we were discussing earlier.
Yeah, Asa's headhunting right now. Oh, he's popping the eye.
Yep, he's in trouble. Heavy knees. in the clinch there, and now they separate. Aces, down he goes. On the attack, Zatout.
Oh. That could have been after the bell right there.
What a way to end the round, and look at the eye of Asa Ten Pow. You were on it, Mitch. Dragon, you were on it. That left eye in trouble, and Zatout is really feeling himself right now.
Yeah, Mitty caught him, and that eye immediately gave Asa Ten Pow some problems. I don't think he can open it. He might not be able to answer the bell. Let's take a look at this. See, that's that movement. Look at that nice little skip right there. Boom. He started to find. Oh, that one right there landed clean on the left side of his face.
That right has been heavy so far in this fight.
Yeah, it's a hammer, and Mehdi throws it with some serious speed. Boop. Look at that. Boom. Right there. Immediately, Asa was like, oh no, this small gloves. These things hurt differently. Really, the first time you get cracked with small gloves, your entire world changes. If you start to rethink your life choices.
It's not just getting cracked with the small gloves, but realizing that you don't have as much space to cover on your defense, particularly with somebody like Asa.
That's it.
He cannot get off the stool, and the fight is over after one round. It's a TKO for that man on the top of the one circle, celebrating. The veteran from Algeria gets it done here tonight in Malaysia. Mehdi Zatout with an incredible 3 minutes of Muay Thai in the bantamweight division, putting on an early show on this incredible fight card tonight.
This was a great performance by Mehdi Zatout. He showed a different kind of level, like how much of higher of a level he is than Asa in this particular match, being able to time him, read his techniques from start to finish. He was just able to calculate it. This is the finishing shot right here. Zatout comes over top, catches him with that right hand, and immediately you can see that Asa is injured here. Zatout was wasting no time on this and wasn't going to take any chances without trying to finish this fight.
Let's be clear, it's tough to get off the stool. Asa Ten Pow, obviously a tough guy, but that situation is tough. Here's Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Justin Brown, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes in the very first round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Mehdi Zatout!
TKO at the end of round one, and his two young children able to celebrate with him. It gets no better than that. Here's the Dragon.
Mehdi, I can see how much this win means to you. You got your family here for the first time inside the circle. What's going through your mind, my friend?
It's so amazing, you know. My shoulder has given me more than 27 years of hard workout, discipline, you know, and I learned a lot. And that makes myself. I just want to thank my shoulder has, because my shoulder has given me everything for my life. Give education for my kids. Give everything. I give my all knowledge to all my athletes. And so, you know, all of you guys, I work a lot and was a lot of sacrifice for me, sorry, to make this fight camp. I work a lot and I'm so happy. I thank God. Alhamdulillah, I win today. Thanks, Malaysia. I love your country.
When you feel good, you look good, and you perform good. That right hand was an absolute hammer tonight. Take a look up here at the big screen, because you landed several before he had enough.
Yeah. You know, I have more than 39 years. Work, like I said, I work out. I can do many things, but I try to see what is game plan. I have many game plan to work with my coach, Chris, and so, right hand, left hand, elbow, was left kick, was mini game plan for today's right hand start. I see I get pain every time I punch. Also, I have the punch, the body first for the body shot was for the second round, but cannot be happen.
Well, I knew that you had, this is 120 fights for you, about that, right? And you had the experience. Did you think that he wouldn't be able to answer the bell and get up off the stool?
I don't know, man.
I just want to back home now and stay with more time with my baby family, because sometimes I work a lot to have time for them, you know.
Yeah, I know you work a lot. I know your family means everything. I can see the emotion that's going through you right now, but I don't think we're done yet, because you just got $50,000 from Chatri Signatong.
Thank you, Queen Chatri. I just want to say that is from the bottom of my heart. Thanks you. Thanks ONE Championship. Thank you, Mish. Thanks, Rick. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, everybody. You are an amazing team. I never see for 27 years in this martial arts, I never work with people like you guys. I know sometimes I'm headache, some people, but it's my style. But I want to thank everybody of you. You are amazing team. I never see that. Nobody can compete with ONE Championship. Inside your heart, inside your work, cannot. Thank you, Kun Chatri. Thank you, everything. Thank you, ONE Championship.
We want to thank you, Diamond Heart. Go enjoy your victory with your incredible family and your team right there.
I just want to say something. This is difficult to say, but I promise my wife, promise my mom, if I win, I have to stop. And I sing an Ashwa. It's my last fight. I follow my heart to say yes, I want to compete. My mind, many works, many things kill my mind. I need to stop to focus on my team, my family. And this today was amazing finish, you know. I want to stop. And so sorry for ONE Championship if I don't fight again.
You have nothing to apologize about. It has been a pleasure to call your fights and to see you perform inside the circle. And what a way to go out. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the Diamond Heart, Mehdi Zatout.
That is sensational. Rich, that's what it is all about. And if that was his last fight, what a way to go out.
You know, Mehdi is 39 years old, and so he's getting to that age where you would start to consider retirement. But there's no better way than to go out with a performance like that. You want to go out on your terms. He's basically at a point where he said, you know what? Martial arts has done everything for me. I've done everything I wanted to do with martial arts, and so here I am. This is my last match. Better to go out like that than off of several knockouts or losses in a row.
And Rich, you can't overstate the fact, $50,000 on top of it. I mean, many people, regardless of what field, what sport they're in, don't get the opportunity to walk away like that.
Listen, after you win and you get your win purse, that is just the exclamation point. It's the punctuation. It's the icing on the cake. There's no better way to go out than with a retirement like that and a $50,000 bonus.
Chatri Signatong with a $50,000 bonus. And what a scene here in the center of the one circle as he takes off the gloves, as he says for the final time with his two kids flanking him on either side and his entire team.
This has been a family affair tonight. First fight, two fathers in the corner. The second fight, we have a celebration with his children.
Man, that's a lot of emotion to get us started here in the lead card, man. There's, if we keep going like this, I don't know how I'm gonna handle it. I'm so pumped up. What a moment, what a great performance. Mehdi Zatout, how can you retire after a performance like that?
Like I'm saying to Brent, that's the best way to go out. Mehdi's 39 years old. You'd rather go out like that on your terms, knowing that he's at that point in his career where he felt like he's done enough. He's got his children here, had one of the best performances of his career, earned a bonus on top of it. And then he says, you know what, I've had enough, rather than coming off of several knockouts.
ONE Championship has the best of the best on the planet. We just saw it right there from a man who says ONE has given him everything. Later on, three world titles, including the first ever lightweight submission grappling belt on the line, featuring Kade Ruotolo of America.
Submission grappling has just met its future.
He likes to fly. He likes to roll. He'll use backflips during a fight.
ONE half of the dynamic Ruotolo twins. Kade made history on the mat.
this last ADCC, I think I made a couple records. I was the youngest to win it. I had four fights, was able to get four submissions. It was a dream come true.
And now, returns to the One Circle in search of more.
One's doing such a great job of bringing kind of the elite of jiu-jitsueros. We have a very strong roster. It's gonna be the first lightweight grappling belt. It'd be amazing to get a finish and be the first to capture that.
While innovative jiu-jitsu brought Kade Ruotolo to this moment, the world championship sambo of Uali Kurzhev could bring an end to his unprecedented run. Driven by pride and discipline, on this massive stage, Kurzhev's mission is clear.
Ну ещё раз повторюсь, что это новая глава для меня. Вот, и на самом деле новые возможности. Я выиграл уже всё и по несколько раз в самбо.
I'm up for anyone. There's really no one that I'm scared of. In the last 2 years, I've kind of shifted my focus into becoming the most aggressive athlete as I can be. I'd rather lose an exciting match than win a boring one.
Я представитель самбо и пришел именно на территорию грэпплинга. Ну, для меня, наверное, победа над Кейдом Ruotolo будет очень значимая.
Last month I became the world's youngest ADCC world champion. Tonight I plan on being the first one lightweight submission grappling world champion.
Я пришел, чтобы вывести самбо на мировой уровень.
I hope the world remembers me as the most exciting jiu-jitsu fighter on the planet.
Man, Kade Ruotolo is going to be inside the center of the One Circle here inside Axiata Arena. We're in Kuala Lumpur. The main card, again, 10 p.m. Eastern, back in the United States, exclusively on Prime Video. Back with the Dragon, former One Fighter Mitch Chilson, Rich Ace Franklin, the Hall of Famer. I'm Brent Stover. I cannot wait. First ever lightweight submission grappling belt going to be handed out tonight. Now, Uali Kurzhev did not make weight, so he cannot win the belt even if he wins the fight. But Kade Ruotolo certainly can. 19-year-old American phenom, trains out of San Diego. A lot to love about this kid.
Yeah, and I just fell more in love with Kade Ruotolo watching this young man tear through the ADCC Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu competition. This guy was an animal. Everybody got finished. He is excitement when he hits the mat. This guy has such an attacking style. He goes after darce chokes and heel hooks, and then he goes up into the air. Watch this. Watch the way that he chooses to take Shinyaoki down. He jumps off of the wall to circle around and take the back of Shinya. The creativity of this young man, the innovation that he is bringing to submission grappling is really something special.
Yeah, I like the way he's very unorthodox. You saw it in his first shot there where he just took Shinya's balance. But I'll tell you, Uali Kurzhev, this guy is tough, and you want to talk about a guy who has strong takedowns. I think the thing he's going to have to overcome in this particular match is the fact that you see it right here. He's training in a gi, and the question is how he is going to deal with someone that is as unorthodox as Ruotolo, who's going to enter from the bottom, inversion guards, leg attacks. How is Uali going to handle that, Mitch?
There's a little bit of a war going on right now between Sambo and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. And now it's going to kind of come to a head. And it's got gold on the line, Brent.
One on Prime Video 2, Mikey Musumeci and the BJJ discipline was pretty dominant. Do we expect BJJ to win out here on one on Prime Video 3 as well?
Man, it's that innovation that Rich talks about. Uali is gonna have to find an answer to the unorthodox movement and the attacking style. Typically, submission grappling is position first and then the submission. They get control and then they start attacking. Kade immediately starts attacking. Everything is attack, attack, submit, submit, finish.
Where Wally's going to run into trouble is you saw that with Shinya when Kade had just ankle picked just to get him off balance, not like that traditional shot where he has to secure position. It's this very unorthodox thing. If he can just get you out of position, he'll take your back, he'll attack a leg, he'll do something that's unorthodox that's just not that standard like position over submission mentality in BJJ.
Will the 19-year-old sensation, whose twin brother is also a sensation, will he take it home? The first ever lightweight submission grappling world title is on the line exclusively on Prime Video as part of the main card. We've had two absolute bangers so far. And coming up next, we go to flyweight Muay Thai. The man from Japan, Taiki Naito. This guy wants to get into a firefight. He wants to come forward and make this electrifying against the veteran, Amir Naseri. Can Naseri get it done? That fight is coming your way next. Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, inside the Axiata Arena. Doors are open, fans beginning to file in, just over an hour away from going live exclusively on Prime Video. In the meantime, flyweight Muay Thai, Naito and Naseri. It's a fight between two elite strikers who have always put on electrifying fights.
Only the best strikers on the planet find success inside the one circle.
The greatest strikers in the world converge in the flyweight Muay Thai division.
Now, these flyweights eye their own future. Amir Naseri gets the opportunity to display his Muay Thai mastery in his home country as he collides with Taiki Naito.
To get the news that they wanted me to come back to the big stage, that was the best news ever, you know. Being here right now is exactly where I want to be. I'm here to win, you know, that's the mindset that I take into every fight. Just can't wait to take over the division.
But for the silent sniper, actions.
Speed and accuracy.
Speak louder.
That is one Super Series Muay Thai!
Than words.
So, this game, if I win, I feel like I'm going to be the next title challenger.
Japan versus Malaysia. Taiki Naito versus Amir Naseri. Next.
Japan wants to superlek his last fight. Wasn't quite good enough, but earned a lot of respect from his performance. Apart from that, has 5 wins in 1, has beaten Tomas Michael, He dropped him with a counterpunch twice, a wide margin victory on the scorecard. He is not ranked at the moment. Maybe doesn't get the headlines he deserves, but he's got an impressive record. Mitch, he's a versatile striker, and a win inside the one circle here tonight would go a long way once again to getting those headlines and becoming one of the elite guys in this division.
Yeah, Brent, that versatility comes from his karate background. He's very well-rounded, he's got smooth boxing, but it's really his kicks that set him apart. And that's gonna be very important here against Amir. Both these guys were quarterfinalists in the Flyweight World Grand Prix, and they really wanna make a name and a statement here to work their way back up and possibly challenge Rotang for the title. But they have a tough test in front of them tonight. Taiki Naito's got beautiful counter striking, and these two match up really well together, especially because Amir likes to come forward and chase, but then watching Taiki Naito slide out of the way. You mentioned that Savas matchup, and that was true to his style. Beautiful counter striking. He is relentless with the low kicks. He punishes people's support legs and really looks for that knockout finish.
Yeah, you talk about that karate style, Mitch, and that's one of the things of beauty about Taiki Naito is that when he's counter striking, all his counter strikes are straight down the pike, and that's what you got to be careful of, because those things come quick, they come fast, and they come very efficient.
Says he expects a close, competitive, and exciting fight, but believes he is the more technical fighter as compared to Naseri. We will find out. He's still ranked number 4 in the flyweight kickboxing division.
Representing Malaysia and Iran, Amir Naseri.
Amir Naseri, representing Iran and Malaysia as well. He was raised right here in Kuala Lumpur, so this is a golden opportunity. This just his second fight in one championship. His first one did not go well. He's talked a lot about that, embarrassed about his performance against Savas Michael. Worst fight he's ever had. The positive is he is so fired up to get back in front of his home crowd inside the one circle. Says he always goes for the finish. He's going to be aggressive, using a lot of elbows, a high knockout rate. He's got a lot to prove here tonight.
Yeah, you know, that matchup against Savas Michael was coming after a long layoff, and it kind of just knocked the rust off, literally and figuratively, at this point. Naseri is a really aggressive Muay Thai-style striker. He likes to push forward. He likes to close that distance, utilize those elbows, and really put a lot of pressure on his opponents, trying to break them. He is one of the first and only non-Thais to win the Omnoi Stadium title, so he's got the skills to really do well here in this division, but he's got to get that mental game together, and I think we're going to see that here tonight, Rich.
Yeah, the mistake he made with Savas Michael was the fact that he got overexcited, and with that, the punches and the strikes, the kicks, they all started coming a little bit wider. He needs to keep himself tighter, because against a guy like Naito, who comes straight down the pipe, that could be dangerous.
Yeah, he's got to cut off that circle. He's got to try to pin Naito in one position and eliminate all that lateral movement. He's got to close the distance and really utilize those elbows. But to set all that up, he's got to go to the body, because Naito is so good at evasion and getting out of the way with that head movement.
Yeah, that evasion is going to be something that he's going to put to the test tonight, because Naseri comes in so committed with that aggression.
He's an exciting fighter, no doubt about that. He should bring fireworks here in mere moments inside the one circle. He's best known for attacking with a ton of elbows, has knockouts in almost half of his career victories. His second fight in one. Tail of the tape. Flyweight Muay Thai, 30 years of age for Naseri, 26 for Naito. 1-inch height advantage for Naseri, 3-inch reach advantage. Our global rules set. 3 3-minute rounds, 10-point must system. 3 knockdowns in a round equals a TKO. Here's Tom Lau.
And now we have 3 3-minute rounds of flyweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he stands at 5'8" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 34 wins and 9 losses. Training out of Bellwood Fight Team, representing Japan, Taiki Silent Sniper Naito! And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5'9" tall, weighing in at 134 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 29 wins and 6 losses. Training out of Tiger Muay Thai, representing Iran and Malaysia, Amir Naseri. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier Cost.
All right, guys, watch out for the headbutt, low blow, and back of the head. You both know the rules. 5-5 clean, touch glove if you want. Back your corner.
Cannot wait for this one. Here in Kuala Lumpur, in our first fight, we saw a first round knockout. In our second fight of the night, saw Asa Ten Pow unable to go after the first round, couldn't get off his stool, a win for Mehdi Zatout.
Judge Ty.
What do we have in store?
Ready?
Choke! For this third fight of the night, the bell in round one. Flyweight Muay Thai, Amir Naseri and Taiki Naito. Naito from Japan, Naseri representing Malaysia as well as Iran, grew up here in Kuala Lumpur. 3 3-minute rounds. Here in Muay Thai, the third of four fights on this lead card. And again, about an hour away from going exclusively on Prime Video for the main card and five fights, including three world titles on the line.
You see Naito early using that push kick and that inside leg kick to mitigate the distance right there. And he's quick the time that Naseri is able, or trying to counter, that is.
Two elite strikers that like to go forward. Nice kick there by Naito into the body of Naseri. A minute gone here in round one.
Yeah, this is the kind of style fight that Naito really likes. He likes to keep you at range. He likes to try to find his distance and his timing and just start touching you. Each little touch gives him a little bit better read on exactly what you're trying to do. This is Naseri's opportunity to really start to change things up. He doesn't want to stand here and trade kicks with Naito like this.
Tried a straight left to Naseri there, unable to land. Hasn't really landed anything yet, but Naseri showing a lot in his arsenal here.
He's got a body kick that almost scored for him right there, but he's getting a good idea exactly what's coming after him from Naito. He's just got to push forward a little bit, start going to the body.
Both fighters in this opening round trying to find that range. A minute 20 left in the first round. Three 3-minute rounds. Flyweight Muay Thai division.
Yeah, Naseri's getting a little bit wild with some of these strikes that he's throwing, especially with the kicks. He hasn't quite found his feet on anything yet.
This is the same mistake that he made against Savas Michael, though, is that he started to get a little wild and then he got impatient with his techniques landing.
Inside leg kick there from Naito, able to land that. Now tries a straight kick, and on the attack comes Naseri. I just mentioned that heavy inside leg kick, and you can see the damage done on the inside of the leg of Amir Naseri.
Good push kick by Naito.
And then the outside leg kick here, coming back for Naseri.
We're just trading leg kicks at this point. Nice combination there as Naseri entered the pocket.
1-2-3 combo from Naseri as he gets aggressive here. Tried the high kick and the spin, and he got caught when he spun and then throws Naito to the canvas.
That shin landed.
Yeah, he got caught coming around, and Naseri acknowledged the kick right there from Naito.
We said at the start, it's a fight between two elite strikers who always put on exciting fights, and they have shown that here in the first round. Good round one. Got two phenomenal fights to start the night. This one living up to the billing so far, Dragon.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's a lot of kicks. This first round was just basically these two trading. You go, I go, you go, I go. I'm gonna make you miss, I'm gonna make you pay. Nice little
cut kick there attempted by Naito as he tried to go take out the support leg. Naseri started to find his rhythm a little bit. He looked a little bit uneasy, but there was that beautiful high kick off of the spin. Naito is able to connect and wrap his shin around the back of the neck.
You see with these kicks that Naito is just a little tighter with
the
kicks. We talked about that karate style. You can see that he's just quicker to the punch slightly in that round.
Yeah, and he's a Naseri is a little bit wider, a little bit more over-exaggerated, almost telegraphing his shots. He's really got to try to keep things tight.
Ready?
Go to those hands, start going to the body and the legs of Naito, because it's hard to hit the head of Taiki Naito.
The bell in round two. Crowd filing in here for this big number fight to Kuala Lumpur inside the Axiata Arena. Again, Naseri grew up right here in this city, so definitely has the crowd on his side against the Japanese-born Naito.
I like that. He caught the push kick and then went after the support leg and upended Naseri. I really like the leg work of Taiki Naito.
Yeah, Naseri needs to change his game plan up here. I wouldn't have started this round off with a push kick because that's just taking you out of range. He needs to start closing this range, pushing Naito's back against that cage. Like you mentioned earlier, Mitch.
Yeah, he doesn't want to stand in the center circle trading kicks with him. He's got to push forward. Right? He comes forward a little bit, and then he gets back into kicking range. Yeah, now he needs to come forward. But he's got to be smart coming forward because Naito is such a smooth counter striker. I know there's a lot of emotion for Naseri. He's competing in front of a lot of friends and family here in KO. This means a lot for him. He kind of grew up, you know, around this stadium, you know, coming to sporting events here. So this means a lot. Another beautiful cut kick landed by Naito.
And Naseri had almost had Naito's back against the cage and then just allowed Naito to quarter turn out and come back around and take center circle again. And now he's back at this same game trading.
Naito been slicing in the first two rounds, that cut kick that you mentioned. Midway through the second round, midway through the fight, lunging in was Naseri. Got caught a little bit that time by Naito.
Oh, no.
Yeah, he overextended, and it's hard to headhunt against Naito if you're not putting combinations together. If you throw just one big shot, he's got the eyes to be able to see, evade, and then touch.
Naito came to play here tonight. Naseri's trying to lock. There's that left hook to the head. Landed on Naito. See if Naseri can put something together here in the final minute of the second round. Outside leg kick, and then he comes with the body kick. Caught by Naito, who trades right back with his left hook. Straight right from Naseri, nothing doing. Is this about what you expected, Mitch, going in?
I expected a little bit more aggression coming from Naseri, and I also expected him to cut the angles a little bit. You can see how Naito kind of circles to his left a lot, and I expect Naseri to really start to cut that angle off, start throwing low kicks to really stop that lateral movement that comes from Naito, and start putting hand combinations together. But this is what I expected completely from Taiki Naito.
Final 10 seconds of round two. Flyweight Muay Thai, wild throw that time by Naito. Kicks it back, wild head kick attempt there from Naseri.
Yeah, you can see that he's just winding up big with those kicks. Naito was completely disappeared on him as that kick came. Not only did he lean back and evade it, but at the same time, he quarter turned, brought his back off of the cage.
The movement has been phenomenal from Naito in the opening two rounds.
Yeah, this is how it started, right? He goes right after that push kick, and then Naito, being the veteran that he is, caught it, swept out the support leg. Look at this. Beautiful. Boom. Takes out the support leg, puts on your butt. It just looks dominant to the judges. You know, it scores, it looks good, and it's also a little bit demoralizing to pick yourself up off the kick.
So it's going down. So just concentrate the head. If you think you can do it, go for it. Is it okay? Go ahead.
Good stuff in the corner of Naito. So what can Naseri do here, Rich, to turn the tide in the final round in a fight that you know, clearly the scorecards, he's down in.
Well, he started off with a push kick in that round, ready, and that keeps ready. Range, but then he started closing the distance, which is what he needs to do. But he needs to be more systematic about the way that he's doing it, getting his head offline, because his head, as he's coming in, is just right in place for Naito to land those straight punches that we've been talking about before that's been influenced by that karate style. You saw that he just ate a jab there on the way in.
He's throwing the feint, like he's changing stances and he's coming forward, but there's no answer. There's nothing after it, right?
10-point scoring system, how do you have it through two rounds?
I gotta give two rounds to Taiki Naito at this point. He's just doing a little bit more. He's touching, he's scoring,
guys,
he's counter-striking.
Ready? Let's go.
Olivier Cost urges him on, says a little bit more action here in the final round.
No.
So unofficial, but the Dragon has it 10-9 in favor of Naito of Japan.
Yeah, Naseri's gonna have to score a knockdown at this point if he wants to keep things in his favor on the judges' scorecard.
See the damage on the nose. Really poking up and getting red there in the nose of Naseri as he comes in with a nice left.
This is exactly what he needs to be doing too, making this fight ugly.
Naseri trying to get aggressive, salvage something inside the final 2 minutes. Mitch mentioned he needs a knockdown. He is certainly going for it, trying to walk down Naito in this third round.
You can almost see Naseri grimace before he throws a punch, right? Like he bites down on his mouthpiece and kind of and he kind of flexes before he's about to go, which is kind of a telegraph.
Yeah, it's all those are all tells, and that's the kind of things that Naito is reading. It's any little thing, a hand that comes back before it actually goes out, a grit of the teeth, these are the tells that lets your opponent know, like, hey, I'm coming. And is it microseconds that count in a fight?
Inside leg kick to the thigh, beautifully by Naito.
That was a body shot that landed. Even though Naito caught it, he still good head movement right there to counter with the left hook. I think Naseri needs another couple of rounds to really find his rhythm, because now he's starting to turn it on, but Naito's touching him as he's coming in.
Minute left here in round three. Obviously, Naseri trying to take some chances here with the jab. And now stepping in, looking for a firefight in the final 50 seconds to do something here in a fight which he's down.
Naseri's got to be careful reaching for that leg kick. You don't want to reach down and try to catch the leg kick. This isn't Muay Thai, this isn't MMA where you can run somebody down for a takedown.
Uppercut, then a left hook from Naseri as he comes alive in the final minute. Naseri.
Anytime your opponent waves it off like that, you know that you actually tagged him.
Naseri with a big right, but it didn't land, and now they're in the clinch. 25 seconds in the fight. Knees coming in from Naseri, and now throws to the canvas Naito.
This KO crowd is letting it know that they appreciate the effort by Naseri as he's trying to go forward. Nice little body kick there. He turns. Got to be careful showing your back like that, though.
Final 10 seconds of this very entertaining fight here in Kuala Lumpur. And that's how it comes to a close. Talk about two guys trying to close the show, Rich Franklin.
I'll tell you, Naseri was headhunting on that last punch that he threw there.
Mitch, you had Naito up on the scorecard after two. Naseri with a huge sense of urgency, give him a lot of credit in the third round.
Yeah, he turned it up. I think he took the warning from Olivier Cost very seriously, and we started to see a lot more of what we expect from Amir Naseri. Now, those kicks were caught, and a nice little answer there. By Taiki Naito. Beautiful leg work. He really just scored a lot of points going to the legs, both inside and outside. Nice little combination, and that's what we needed from Amir, is to get out of the way and come back strong and really start to put the hand combinations together. You can see these guys are just two very exciting flyweights.
Tom Lau has the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Taiki Naito!
No surprise, Rich, he really took control from the opening bell.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, the series started making a run. We saw that replay there where he landed that nice three-piece. That was the best combination that he had landed in the entire match. It was just too little, too late. He needed to be doing that all three rounds, and Naito had just taken way too much of a lead.
Right, the Dragon is with the winner.
Taiki, is this the type of fight you expected to get out of the way, counter from that oncoming pressure that came from Amir Naseri?
この今の試合なんですけども、これが内藤さんがこのような試合をしたがっていた内藤さんのタイプの好みのタイプの試合だったでしょうか。
いや、今日はちょっともう少しこうパンチでアグレッシブというか倒しに行きたいなと思ってたんですけど、なかなかちょっと今回できなかったかなって思うんで、今回はまた次回にできるようにしたいなと思ってます。
As a matter of fact, I was planning on something else. I wanted to strike with more punches this time, more aggressively. However, it turned out like this. So I would very much like to do that in the next fight.
You did a really good job of going backwards. I know you wanted to go forward and apply a lot of pressure, but at what point did the game plan change?
でその前に出てそのもっと圧力をかけるということを考えていたと思うんですけれども、この後ろに下がるというところでも、とても良い仕事をされたと思います。でその戦略が変わったのはどういった理由からでしょうか。
そうですね、やっぱり思ったよりも、まあ、ナセリ選手のプレッシャーが結構強くて、変に突き合うと良くないかなと思ったんで、ちょっとプラン変更してちょっとカウンター狙いになっちゃいましたね。
Mr. Naseri was applying more pressure than I had expected, so I had to change my plan and to manage that strong pressure from him.
The flyweight Muay Thai division is stacked. What's next for the Silent Sniper?
それではサイレンススナイパーと呼ばれている内藤選手ですけれども、ムエタイフライ級で次はどういったことを考えていらっしゃいますか。
もうそうですね、誰が来ても自分はチャンピオンになるために、一生一生勝っていくというか、一生一生コツコツベルトを取るためにこれからも勝ち続けていきます。でキックボクシングの方も自分はランキング入ってますし、チャンピオンは全然まだ防衛戦やってないと思うんで、そこも狙っていきたいなと思ってます。
Whatever comes to me, I will justwin one fight, one by one, and I will concentrate on one match by one match. And I'm ranked in kickboxing as well, so I would very much like to work hard on that, on both Muay Thai and kickboxing.
Well, we look forward to your return. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Taiki Naito!
Taiki Naito of Japan.Domination, a unanimous decision victory over Amir Naseri. Impressive stuff from that young man inside the one circle. Up next will be the feature bout of the lead card, but later on the main card, it's the co-main event for the one lightweight Muay Thai world title. Regian Eersel takes on Sinsamut Klinmee.
18 wins in a row.Regian Eersel, the immortal. This man is the very best.
Unrelenting.
Once he figures you out, there is no stopping the immortal.
Undeniable.
Towering presence of the champion.
His pressure is so intense, he just melts his opponent.
Undefeated. The greatest lightweight kickboxer on the planet, Regian Eersel.Puts on the 4-ounce gloves for Muay Thai gold.
Undefeated for 6 years, and I'm the most dominant kickboxer in one championship. I bring war to the table.
Sinsamut Klinmee!
There it goes! Drops him!
One punch dominance.
Man, that kid's got power!
Sinsamut Klinmee.The brightest young star in the sport, in the midst of a powerful rise.
แค่ว่าเขาจะเป็นนักชกไร้พ่ายมาจากไหนผมไม่สนใจเขาเป็นแชมป์คิกบ็อกซิ่งแต่นี่เราชกกันมวยไทยนี่มันทางของผม
The media hype and attention on is great for him. When I beat him, the attention goes to me.
Ik ben graag dominant, agressief naar voren, onvoorspelbaar.
ความเร็วแล้วก็อาวุธของเขาไม่หนักก็คือคางเขาเปาะ
I'm mentally prepared for him. I want to finish this fight in a spectacular KO.
ไม่แคร์ว่าเขาจะเป็นแชมป์มาจากไหนเป็นนักชกไร้พ่ายมาจากไหนผมอาจจะใหม่นะแต่ผมน็อกมา2 ครั้งแล้ว ุณเป็นครั้งที่3
I visualize myself with my hands in the air with two belts around me. My goal in my career is to write history and the only way to do it is to become two sports world champion.
มวยไทยรุ่นไลท์เวทคนแรกได้สุดว่าเขาไม่ใช่นักสู้ที่ฆ่าไม่ตาย
At the end of the day the goal is to win andI'm pretty good at that. I will go down in the books as the first lightweight Muay Thai world champion.
Inside the Axiata Arena, fans filing in. 40 minutes away from the main card exclusively on Prime Video. That'll be the co-main, one of three world titles on the line. Man, you better check your pulse. If you're not excited about this lightweight Muay Thai battle,Then I don't know why you're here.
Oh, man. Sinsamut Klinmee fires me up. He has stormed into one super series with two incredible knockouts of not just anybody. Two former world champions, Nicky Holskin and Liam Nolan. The way that this guy hits people lays them out. It is something special to watch this guy. But the most dominant...kickboxing champion we've ever had in Regian Eersel, the immortal one. He knows no wrong.
I'll tell you what, when I think of Regian Eersel, I think of smooth. This guy's a technician. The problem he's going to have with this match is that Klinmee has that one-punch knockout power. And in all the highlights that you just saw there of Regian Eersel, those are big gloves. We're in small gloves tonight. And Regian Eersel fights, even though he has a 5-inch reach advantage in this match, he fightslike a shorter fighter. He likes to get on the inside. That could be problematic for him against this guy.
Sinsamut Klinmee arriving here inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur. Regian Eersel as well. Both men looking in perfect shape, very relaxed, walking into the arena. Eersel, man, there is a lot to love about this man, Mitch Chilson.
Yeah, Regian Eersel, the five-time lightweight kickboxing world champion, is really something special. The way that he closes distance and those flying knees are spectacular. The setup of how he throws them is really intriguing. And he says he wants to put those on display tonight because he sees holes in Sinsamut's game that's going to allow him to attack with those knees. But you said it too soon. You do not want to close distance with this guy, Rich.
Absolutely not. Sinsamut is that guy that has that one-punch KO power. He's done it against Holskin like you talked about before. And if Regian thinks that he wants to close the distance with somebody like that, that's what he's going to have to watch out for. Because Sinsamut can, like a spring that's coiled, can just hammer you away.
Who's got the edge of this massive fight with a world title on the line later on tonight?
Oh, you're putting me on the spot like that?
Of course I am, Dragon.
Oh, no. I don't know. You got to give the experience to Regian Eersel. The game planning, the methodical mind that this young man has is really something special. But the one-hitter, quitter, that Sinsamut carries with him is the great equalizer.
X factor in this match, four-ounce gloves. Four-ounce gloves.
As for prediction, I don't know that I actually got one. You played it perfectly politically.
I'm on the fence.
That's politics, Brent. That's politics.
Co-main event coming up in about 40 minutes from now, exclusively on Prime Video. It's 10 p.m. Eastern back in the United States. Coming up, featured bout on the lead card. If you have never seen these guys, you are in for a firefight and a real treat. Catchweight MMA, bout four of the night. Jeremy Miado and Danial Williams. These guys will absolutely put on a show, Dragon.
Oh, yeah. The thing is with Jeremy Miado, it's that knockout power. Look at him taken to the air. Watch these hands. Look at the angles he starts to create. He can put a beating on you, and that's with a loud stadium. He really has some ferocious knockout power. He's got almost 80 striking matches, but he faces Mehdi T, Rich.
Yeah, Mehdi T, and Mehdi T made his splash in one championship against a guy like Rawtang, but you see him getting worked on here against Desjum Rong. And with that body shot, Mehdi T has that one punch power as well. This is going to be a very interesting matchup between these two guys. I don't look for this one to go to the ground.
Miado did not make weight, so it's a catchweight bout in the MMA division. Danial Williams comes in ranked number 5. It'll be an explosive and exciting clash of strikers with deadly finishing ability as Mehdi T
backstage in his locker room getting set to go against the dangerous Jeremy Miado. Feature fight on the lead card when we come back. Each. Oh, good start from Gucci. Oh, but he gets caught and it's finished.
It's got its own gravitational pull. Charges after Galani early. Looking for a takedown, trying to put hands. Oh, Galani catches it!
The spinning back fist, looking to finish, and he does!
Very successful one, unbeaten in his three contests.
Juanel is coming off a nasty heel hook submission.
Oh, he got
The big kibosh! Juanel, the hammer fist strike!
Michelle, man, has really been focused on his footwork and his stand-up boxing.
Good hands from him.
Oh, and Jimmy Yamo comes out of nowhere.
Urujai said he did more sparring in training in this camp than ever before. Kali knocks out the Cambodian. This place will go bananas. Oh, there's the left hook. Oh, he does that. Listen.
As she did that, she let her guard get past.
Now, oh, a heavy hand. Ev's got to be careful not to drop his gloves too low. Oh, Ev taking in trouble. It's good night, Irene.
Inside the Axiata Arena, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It's the feature bout on our lead card, and we cannot wait. Catchweight battle, Miado and Williams. Both guys say they will strike. Both think they are the superior striker. The rubber meets the road. Something's got to give in mere moments.
Mini T, Danial Williams. A little thunder from down under.
This guy is no joke.
Highlight reel, one punch KO. That's huge!
The right hand, man. It's a weapon.
Danial Mini T Williams calling out everybody.
I'm the guy to beat in this division. You want to talk about true martial artists? That's me. I'm knocking on the title shop.
Hindi ko alam kung bakit sa kanya lahat napupunta yung atensyon ng mga tao. Galing din ako sa 3-win streak, lahat yung TKO. If you're talking about great fighter, you're talking about Jeremy Miado.
Jeremy Miado, the wild card.
He's had a dangerous stand-up game. Jeremy Miado just shot the world!
One championship has a lot of good strikers at strawweight. That's my background. Jeremy Miado, not intimidated at all.
Masyado siyang maraming sinasabi. Kung akala niya ganun kadali ang makuha ng title shot, nagkakamali siya dun. Kailangan niya muna akong kaharapin.
The person standing in front of me, he's trying to end me. That just doesn't sit well with me. It's war.
Kung gusto niyang sabayan sa striking, mas maganda yun. Kasi makikita natin kung sinong unang matutulog.
It's my destiny to be a world champion.
Hindi na ako makapaghintay na patahimikin siya.
Mini T always brings violence, beautiful violence.
Representing Australia and Thailand, Mini T, Danial Williams.
Danial Williams. He's a showman. He's an electrifying fighter. He's 3-0 in one championship and riding a 5-fight winning streak overall. Another win against the division's most dangerous knockout artist could push him further up the rankings and toward a world title
shot. His only loss came at flyweight. Mentioned he's on a five-fight winning streak and won a $50,000 bonus in his last fight. This man, Dragon, is worth the price of admission and then some.
I'll quote Mini T on this one. Mini T brings beautiful violence, and it all comes out of that right hand. That is such a weapon of his. He can go to the body. He can knock you out with the head. He is a spectacular striker, and I really like that mullet that he's growing. But what I also like is his ability to adapt to game plans. This is going to be a really interesting matchup between two high-level strikers. He spent 4 weeks prepping for this. He wants to create those angles and really put a pace on him. He's currently riding a five-fight win streak, five knockouts and six wins, and a lot of that has come from that big right hand, Rich.
Yeah, I do like the way that Mini T is able to adapt his game. You saw, for example, a much different Mini T versus Rod Tang as opposed to like an Amiki Kawahara, right? He's able to adapt that style. Where Mini T has to still prove to me is what he's capable of on the ground. We've seen him proficient on the ground, but Miado is going to bring a completely different threat in this match.
From the Philippines, Jeremy the Jaguar Miado.
Jeremy Miado, all smiles, representing the Philippines, has won four of his last five, entered the rankings earlier this year, been pushed out since, so a chance to get back in those rankings here tonight. Big time striker. His knockouts are almost always very spectacular. If he wins it, it'll be the second former Muay Thai world champ that he has beaten. A feature bout on this lead card, and Miado in this catchweight MMA battle looks like he's ready to go, Dragon.
Yeah, there's a reason why this is the featured bout. This was Rich's favorite fight possibly in the lead card, with good reason, because since moving to Maroc Force, Jeremy Miado has really leveled up and made a full commitment to his development, and we have seen it. The way that he's able to utilize that boxing is really something special. Now, keep in mind, he's had over 80 fights, amateur kickboxing and boxing. He's a very experienced striker with some serious power. He's currently riding a three-fight win streak. All of his wins have come via knockout. And seven finishes out of those 11 wins, man. This guy is really exciting. I'm looking forward to this matchup, Rich.
I'll tell you what, he promised that he was going to just throw strikes tonight, but I think that the path of least resistance is the ground game for him. Let's see if he goes there.
The keys will be his reach and speed advantage as we check out the tail of the tape. 29 years of age for both of these men. 1-inch height advantage, Miado. 3-inch reach advantage. With his freestyle background, Williams ranked number 5 in a Muay Thai background for him. Global rules, 3 5-minute rounds, bout judged as a whole. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. Here's Dom Lau.
Rounding up the lead card, we have 3 5-minute rounds in a 127-pound catchweight MMA contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the number 5 strawweight contender and a WMC Muay Thai world champion, standing at 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 6 wins and only 1 loss. Training out of scrappy MMA and Kalsuk Muay Thai, representing Australia and Thailand, Mini T, Danial Williams. And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5 feet 7 inches tall, weighing in at 127 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 11 wins and 4 losses. Training out of Merrick Force, representing the Philippines, Jeremy the Jaguar Miado. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Herb Dean.
Daniel.
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. Let's keep it clean. Touch gloves and let's do it.
Kurt Dean has got him ready to go in this catchweight MMA battle.
Judge.
One championship time. Has the most decorated roster in the world with over 170 fighters who have won world championships in major organizations.
Ready.
And we're seeing some of that talent on display in this feature bout on the lead card, the bell and round number one.
Yeah, the jab is going to be important early for Miado to find that range. He's got a little bit of a reach on Daniel, and he's going to want to put that jab out there and stay nice and tight. He's got to be careful with that right hand, though.
Yeah.
Dean steps in here.
Caught him in the groin there, just an inadvertent catch. Daniel's just shaking it out, giving him a few seconds,
okay,
and then they're back at it.
Here we go. 3 5-minute rounds. And again, judged as a whole as opposed to round by round in this MMA battle between Miado and Williams. Williams, rank number 5, coming in.
Good level change there early on from Mini T as he's throwing those feints.
Jeremy Miado's doing a good job of managing this range, though.
Experience advantage is going to have to go to Jeremy Miado.
Right hand touched him.
Yeah, it did. Straight right, and then responding with a straight left is Miado. Miado with a heavy right.
Miado looks fast early on. That jab.
What a 1-2 from Miado there. Outside leg kick responded to Williams with a straight right. Oh, another 1-2 Miado.
Wow.
Touched him on the chin with the right.
The looping right hand of Mini-T versus that, those beautiful straight punches. Woo! That uppercut, though, that touched him on the chin.
Miado, and now Williams wisely gets into the clinch here with his back up against the fence.
I'm just going to say this, that if this round continues like this, it's going to be a tough one to judge because these guys are touching each other with some power.
Here's the first takedown attempt by Miado. Miado's grappling is underrated. I've seen him work with a lot of high-level wrestlers and grapplers out there at Rock Force. And he's been looking sharp lately. Get that body lock. Ends up in side control from Mini-T. This is the first test Mini-T's really going to see on the ground, Rich. I know you spoke about it.
Absolutely. This is where we're going to see what Mini-T's made of in MMA. But you talked about it right. Like, Miado has been underrated, particularly in the grappling category. But I'll tell you, you've seen some great grappling with him. In his match against Maui Tao and against Adewong, he looked great on the ground, and this is exactly what I said his path of least resistance to winning this match would be.
Yeah, he changed up his game plan pretty quick after a couple of those right hands. Even though he was landing on the feet, I like this change of strategy. Easy pass, the half guard here, steps over into full mount. Miado is in complete control. You can see Williams tried to hit bump to create that space and that escape, but he might give up his back in the process. You gotta keep your arms real tight. You don't wanna start extending your arms and start reaching for things if you're Williams.
Yeah, I don't think Miado's gonna look for a submission here. He's looking to pin an arm down, get him in a position where he can just land some punches, do a little bit of ground and pound.
Mini-T needs those Tyrannosaurus Rex arms. You need to keep your arms nice and tight to your body and then start pushing off your opponent so you create that space. When you're on top and doing damage, you don't want that space. On the bottom, you need to create that movement, and that's what that space gives you.
2 minutes to go here in round one in this MMA battle. Mini-T on his back. Miado looking to unload with his barrage of punches. Saw him throw a few rights a moment ago.
Good job. Get that underhook. Now he's going overhook on the other side, but Miado was wise to it. Sucks in the arm, pins it down. He's trying to pass into half, but beautiful job by Daniel Williams to not only retain full guard, but then to get his back up against the wall so he can start working his way back up.
Using that wall to his advantage. Mini-T desperate to get back on his feet.
He's got
to
be a little bit more technical here, trying to work his way back up. See how he's trying to do these big motions, but he does. One big motion, he gets back up to his feet. But Miado's going to drag him back down here.
Mini-T finds that fence again, though, with his back. Mini-T. On home base here for Mini-T, just in desperation, finally able to get out of this. And they return to the center of the one circle to trade strikes in the final minute of round one.
This is important when they came off the break like that. Miado.
Oh, there he goes. Mini-T takes a knee. Miado on top. Miado unloading rights. Is this it for Daniel Williams?
Good resiliency shown by Williams. Let's see if he can survive the round here.
There's a knee to the head of Williams as he gets back on his feet. Takes a straight right.
They're swinging and banging.
That right hand hurt Miado as well.
Miado throwing everything right now. Now knees for both men. Bloody nose, bloody face to Mehdi T. But he continues to stand in the pocket and throw strikes.
Look at Miado throwing the spinning elbows.
Back and forth they go.
This is crazy. Miado's learning the mini T that wouldn't go away when he fought Rautang. This is exactly the resilience we were talking about earlier, Mitch.
As advertised, Miado and Williams, as Miado goes to the air for the flying knee.
Flying knee, Miado didn't land it. Mini T stays in there, blood streaming down his face. Oh, big time overhand right from Jeremy Miado. This final minute has been sensational. What more do you want?
Great first 5 minutes for these two remarkable athletes. Look at some of this action. Look at Mehdi T winding up that right hand. Boom, but he gets caught by one. Sat down by Miado, who follows it up with a knee on the takedown attempt. There's Miado. Look at these two. Just when Mehdi T worked his way back up, they just started trading, going after it. I like the little pauses, the little feints thrown by Miado. He pauses, he skips a beat, and then he enters in to try to finish him off. But Mehdi T being super tough, managed to hang in there.
There's so much going on in that replay. Hands, elbows.
I want one, two.
Hands up.
Hands out. Seconds out.
Guys, let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Hands up, chin down.
Hands up, chin down, ones and twos is what they want.
Yeah, the corner was trying to implore Mehdi T to stay tight, not get into that firefight, not try to get wild with him, not stand in the pocket and trade with Miado, because Miado hits from some awkward angles. It's hard to keep up with him when he's just swinging like that.
The bell in round two. Again, the fight judged as a whole.
Mehdi T is wearing it right now.
Absolutely, but he continues to stand in and trade.
Yeah,
straight
look at the
right.
Left side of his face.
He's going to throw a right hand like that. He needs to step in and actually commit to that thing. Otherwise, he's going to be standing right in Miado's range for a leg kick or a counter right of his own.
Miado with a 1-2 there. Nice right from Miado.
You got to wonder how many he recovered from that massive right hand thrown by Miado in the first five.
It wasn't just the right hand, but keep in mind, Miado followed up with the knee.
Yes. Yeah. It was like right in his path. Perfect. Opportunity to throw a knee while his opponent was on the ground. Nice counter punch there from Mehdi T.
Perfectly legal in one champion.
Absolutely. Inside leg kick, Miado. We've seen a couple of those early on in the first minute of the second round from Jeremy Miado trying to take down the fifth ranks, Danial Williams.
Going back to those leg kicks would be a good idea for Mehdi T too. Miado's got that wide stance. He's also stopped some of that explosiveness and movement that's coming from Miado right now. Daniel's doing a good job of creating the angles though.
Yeah, but he's walking right into Miado's range and just being right at the tip of the punches and allowing himself to get hit or clipped on the way in.
Yeah. You see how he's circling to the power side too? He just keeps moving to the other side, maybe trying to cut those angles off of Miado. He's got to mix. He's at a slight disadvantage when it comes to the boxing, it seems.
Mehdi T looking to counter, a feint there, 320 in round two. Again, inside light kick from Miado. 1-2 Miado, counter attack from Mehdi T. Mehdi T going for the body, wild left hook there.
Yeah, that was good. That was a good change of things. He's kind of just headhunting on Miado. He's got really good eyes and really good reactions and head movement. Going after the legs and going after the body is smart money.
Inside, yeah, inside, then doubled up on the outside leg kick, did Mehdi T.
Yeah, Miado has found Mehdi T's rhythm at this point in time. And so right there, you see he landed another right hand. I love the way that Mehdi T was throwing those kicks before, and he needs to keep doing that, yep, because that's stuff that Miado hasn't picked up on yet. That's how he's going to score.
Mehdi T working those legs, as you said, mixing it up, Mitch.
Yeah, he's got to do that. He can't just stand here. He's got to utilize all the weapons. You don't want to box with Jeremy Miado because boxing is what he wants you to do with him. He wants to stand there and trade hands with you. But Mehdi T's creating some angles, but he's got to start firing those leg kicks. Keep those things coming. And don't throw them blind, too. Don't just throw one leg kick like he just did. He's got to put the punches in front of it and then throw that leg kick.
Yeah, but prior to that leg kick, he walked right into range, and Miado was able to land a jab and then another 1-2 right after it.
Blood coming from the eyes and the nose here of Danial Williams. Final 2 minutes, second round. 3 5-minute rounds. Judge as a whole, body kick.
kick there from Mini T.
Yeah, now Mini T's starting to utilize those kicks. That's where he needs to go. He's utilized that world-class Muay Thai experience that he's got and start the movement of Jeremy Miado. The explosiveness that comes out of Miado is generated a lot by his lower body, and beating on the legs is going to be a good way to slow down some of that movement from Miado.
Left hook to the face there from Miado. Then a straight right countered by Mini T. 90 seconds in round two.
Mini T gets into problems when he stands right in front of him. When he's moving, when he gets in and then he gets out, he's out of that range. But once Miado finds that range, boom, right there. That's when he needs to start moving.
You know, Miato's only got a 2-inch reach advantage on Mini T, but that is enough for Mini T to be able to just walk into that range and Miado pick at him the way that he's been doing this match.
But the way that Miado kind of turns his shoulders and extends.
Oh, there he goes. Miado, but back to his feet. Mini T says, I'm okay, but he takes a left hook. And then another left.
He's in
and
trouble.
A right hook.
He's in trouble.
Miado has got him in trouble.
Oh, turns him into a wrestler. Look at Jeremy Miado touching
on. He's not on steady legs.
Right hook again. He's thrown about five hooks as Miado.
Yeah,
an overhand right.
Miato's being very patient here. This is very smart. He's not swinging wild.
Snaps it.
He's not
going
to allow Mini T to catch him.
I mean, Miado bringing a barrage of everything. A straight right.
Mini T has
left
got
hook.
A chin. He is ultra tough. Rontaine couldn't get him out of there. But Jeremy Miado is hitting him from some serious angles with power.
I love the way that Miato's picking his combinations right now. He hit him with that two-piece and then backed off. He didn't try to keep going there. He knows, even when Mini T is hurt, that he's dangerous.
He is snapping that jab to good effect here in the later stages of round two. Mini T continues to try to walk him down there. Took one at the end. Took some serious leather to the face. What a second round in this featured bout with the lead card.
Yeah, that was a nice 5 minutes put in there by Jeremy Miado. I wouldn't mind seeing a takedown from Miado at this point, especially when Mini T's
exactly
loaded up with that right
you
hand.
You gotta land that right hand. Keep circling to the.
Yeah, you beat it when you counter.
What are you seeing, Rich?
Right there, this is where Mini T, he throws that kick, but he stays in range. He got caught on the way out. You see him moving here, and he's still just in range. Like, he's either got to engage on his terms, or he's got to step back. Right there, he makes the mistake after the kick. That was just his punctuation. He's got to keep talking, basically. He's got to move out of the way, angle off, not allow himself to get caught in that range. After 10 minutes of action, there's been enough damage to Mini T that I'm almost believing at this point he's going to have to finish Miado.
Top of the hour, the main card begins exclusively on Prime Video. But in the meantime, one final round, 5 minutes to go in this MMA battle, catchweight battle between Miado and the fifth-ranked Mini T, Danial Williams.
Yeah, you said it in the second round, Rich, that Miado is looking very patient. He's composed. He's not going all out. He's just picking his shots continually, looking for a goal.
Miado locked him down. Miado on the attack. That's it. Herb Dean calls it in the opening minute of the final round. Jeremy Miado.
That is beautiful. And I'll tell you what that is that's high fight IQ right there. Because Mini T, I don't care how hurt you have him, he's still dangerous. And Miado was just patient all the way through the second round, into the third round, picking his shots, not getting greedy with the combinations, one, two pieces at a time, angling off, and then coming back with another two piece. That was some beautiful boxing skills from Jeremy Miado.
Dragon, incredible stuff.
Yeah, Jeremy Miado has found a new level and put it on display. Look at those boxing combinations. Down the middle, little angles, uppercuts, hooks. Spectacular display by the Jaguar. Look at that, Rich.
Two-piece, he throws the two-piece, then he pauses, angles off, and then throws another two-piece. Beautiful technique.
Tom Lau to make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Herb Dean, has called a stop to this contest after 31 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Jeremy Miado!
place you've been there, you've had that emotion when you know you just took a massive step in your career like Miado just did.
Well, you know, Miado said it at the beginning. He said there's so much hype on Mini T. He's been overlooked. This is a guy, he knows right now that this has been a big stepping stone for him to move up in this weight class. Three knockouts prior to this match. He comes in, puts on an amazing performance, and stops this one. That's four in a row.
The Dragon standing pie with a winner.
I'm here with Jeremy Miado. Jeremy. KL. Show your love. Jeremy Miado, what a performance. The boxing was on point. I can see the emotion all over your face. What's going through your mind right now?
First of all, I would like to thank God for giving me this victory. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much to my team, my coaches, my wife, Chesla, my one and only son, Tobiko. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I don't know what to say, but Sir Chatri, my 50K. I'm ready. My family is ready for that. I really need that one. Thank you so much, Emra. Thank you so much to my team, my family, and then people of the Philippines. Kuala Lumpur, thank you so much for the support. Make some noise!
It seems you have found a new level. You've really put together a good win streak, but you've just leveled up and just really showcased some high-level striking. What do you owe these improvements to?
I work every day. I train like a minimum of 6 hours a day, every day, no fucking rest. That's why I think I deserve this one. And then top five, you know who's the real deal in this division. I'm coming for you. I'm coming that bell. Give me fight in Manila on December 5. I'm ready. I can put another show for you guys.
Well, let's take a look at the show you just put on. Take a look up here at the big screen. You were angling off, creating some beautiful positions, and really putting your punches together. Tell us what's going through your mind at some of these shots.
In the first round, I feel it. I can take his power. And then I saw it. I hit him with the right hand. And then I see in his face, he feel it. So I just find the timing, the right hand and left hook. So we're working that every time, you know, that's our game plan. So when he kick, I throw right and then counter with a hook because I saw his fight in Rotang. He just, Rotang caught him with a hook and then another hook and then cross, then he get knocked down. So see
it. It was a beautiful striking display. I know you just took out the number 5 ranked contender. So you want somebody in the top 4, maybe in Manila. I think that's a fun fight to make. KL. Make some noise for your winner, Jeremy Miado!
Oh, Miado, that was very impressive here inside the One Circle. Oxiana Arena, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Top of the hour, exclusively on Prime Video, the main card, including 3 world title fights. We wrap up the lead card from Kuala Lumpur right after this.